Hello everyone, today I will teach you about the set. So what is set? A set is a collection of data or well-defined distinct object. What is set? Set is a collection of data or well-defined distinct object. So let's take one example. Suppose I said you have to write the set of first five natural numbers. The set of first five natural numbers. So what are the answer? What you will say? You will say that first five natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So these all numbers are called the elements or member of set. These all five numbers are called elements or member of set. Now to represent the set there are two methods. The first method is roster method or tabular method. This is the first method, roster or tabular method. And second method is set builder or rule method. So in first method, roster method, what do you have to do? What is roster method? In this method we have to represent all the members in the braces. Braces means bracket. All the elements of the set we have to represent in braces, and we have to separate each number with the help of commas. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So such method is called roster or tabular method. Now second method is set builder and rule method. In this method we have to write the common property of all the elements. These elements are natural numbers. So common property is that these all five numbers are natural numbers. So how we have to start? Beginning we have to do like this. In bracket we have to write x such that these all x values belong to natural number. Natural number we have to denote with capital N. Then comma. These all numbers are less than 6. So we will write all the values of x are less than 6. Then we have to close the bracket. This method of representation is called set builder or rule method. So these are the general points that you have to remember for first exercise. Now we will start solving some question of your textbook. Now see question number 2. Question number 2 of your text. Question is A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then which of them are true? We have to identify whether the given statement is correct or incorrect. First part is 6 belong to A. This symbol is called belong to. We have to check here whether 6th element is coming in set A or not. This is the set A. In this set A, 6 is coming. That means this statement is true. Second part. 7 belong to sign is cancelled. That means we have to say this is not belong to. We will read it. Not belong to. 7 not belong to A. We will check it. is the 7 coming in this set A? 7 is not coming. That means 7 is not belong to, 7 does not belong to A. This is also 7 not belong to A. That means this statement is true. Fourth part. Fourth part is this. 1, 2 and 3 elements are written inside the curve bracket. That means this is the set. Set A and set 1, 2 and 3 belong to this set A. First thing is here brackets are there. That means this is the set. Then set does not belong to this set A. Only elements belong to A. If it instead of this, it will be written like this. 1 belong to A or 2 belong to A or 3 belong to A, then we will say that this statement is true. But here in this part, what is given? Set 1, 2 and 3 belong to A. So this statement is false. So like this, you have to do all the remaining part of this question. Now see question number 5th. Fifth question. Express each of the following set in tabular form and set builder form. We have to write in tabular form and set builder also. Another name of tabular form is roster. And another name of set builder form is rule method. So we have to write in roster form also and in rule method also. And question is, the set of positive integer. We have to write positive integers. So positive integer starts from 1. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. Up to which number we have to write? We did not mention in the question that up to which numbers we have to write. So we will put here so on. That means this answer will goes on like this only. So such method of representation is called roster or tabular forms. We have to write both roster on tabular form also, and we have to write rule method also. So now we have to write second method, that is rule method. So in rule method, what you have to do? You have to write the property, common properties of these elements. So what is the common property? The common property is that these all are the positive integer. So how we will write? Beginning we have to do like this. X such that X belong to I. I means integer. These all values belong to integer, and X value is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. That means these all values are greater than 0. These all values are greater than 0. That means X is greater than 0. So this is your rule method or set builder method. Now see next part. Next part, you see part number 3rd. Third part. Third part is the set of factors of 24. We have to write the set of factors of 24. We have to write both methods. First method, roster or tabular method, and second method is set builder or rule method. We have to write both the methods. So in roster and method, what we have to do? We have to represent all the elements and we have to separate them with the help of commas. So we have to write all the elements. 24 factors we have to write. Factors means in which table 24 is coming. 24 is coming in a table of 1. So 1 is the factor of 24. How many times it will come in a table of 1? 24 times. 1, 24, ja? 24. That means 24 is also a factor of 24. Next, in 2 table also 24 is coming. How many times it will come in 2 table? 2, 12, ja? 24. That means 12 is also a factor of 24. Next, 3 table. 3, 8, ja? 24. That means 3 is also a factor and 8 is also a factor of 24. 3 and 8. Now, in 4 table also, 24 is coming. 4, 6, ja? 24. That means 4 and 6. Both are the factors of 24. So, these all numbers are the factors of 24. So, such representation is called roster. Now, we have to write rule method. In rule method, we have to write the common property. What is the common property? Common property is that these all are the factors of 24. So, how we will write x such that x is a factor of 24. Like this, you have to do all the part of this question. See, next part. Fourth part is the set of prime factors of 45. We have to write the set of prime factors of 48. We have to write both methods. We have to write roster also and rule method also. Prime factors of 48 we have to write. First of all, we will find the factors of 48. Factors of 48 are 48 is coming in a table of 1. How many times this 48 will come? 1, 48 is 48. That means 1 and 48 both are factor of 48. In 2 table also it is coming. In a table of 2, 48 is coming how many times? 24 times. So 24 is also a factor. In a table of 3, 48 will come. 3, 16, ja. 16, 3, ja. 48. That means 3 is also a factor and 16 is also a factor. Then in a table of 4, how many times it will come? 4, 12, ja. That means 4 is also a factor and 12 is also a factor of 48. Then in a table of 6, 8 ja 48. That means 6 is also a factor and 8 is also a factor of 48. So these all are the factors of 48. But what we have to write? We have to write the prime factors. So which prime numbers are there in this? 2 is a prime number. 3 is a prime number. Only 2 numbers are here which are prime. So we have to write here 2, 3. So this is the answer of roster method. Now we have to write in rule method. In rule method, what you have to do? Beginning, you have to do like this. X such that X is a prime factor of 48. This is the answer of this rule method. Now see one more part. Fifth part is the set of natural number which are perfect square. We have to write the set of natural numbers which are perfect square and are less than 50. So, we have to write both the methods, set builder and roster also. Roster method we have to write and set builder or rule method. So what he is asking in this question? He is asking we have to write the perfect squares which are less than 50. What is the meaning of this perfect square? Let's see here. 1 is the perfect square of 1. 4 is the perfect square of
2.
9 is the perfect square of
3.
16 is the perfect square of
4.
25 is the perfect square of
5.
36, 49. So what he is asking, we have to write the perfect squares which are less than 50. So 1 is the perfect square. If we will do the square of 1, we will get answer 1. If we will do square of 2, we will get answer 4. Like this, if we will do square of 7, we will get the answer 49. So how we will read this? We will read 1 is a perfect square of 1. 4 is a perfect square of
2.
9 is a perfect square of 3. Like this we have to read. And these all numbers are less than 50. So in roster method, what you have to write? You have to write 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36 and 49. So these all members will come in this roster method. Now we have to write rule method. How you will write this rule method? Beginning, we have to do like this, x such that. Now we have to make one formula here. First of all, these all values we had written here. These all are the values of x. That means these all are values of x. And here we will observe that in first square we are taking 1. In second number we are taking 2. In third we are taking 3. In fourth we are taking 4. So in each and every step we are observing that numbers are getting changed. So let's give one alphabet to these values. Let's say these are n. These values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These all values are n. We are given one alphabet name. And on each value we are observing that square is there. That means on n we have to put the square. So we got one formula here. X is equal to n square. So we will write here x is equal to n square. Now what is this n? We have to mention here what is this n. N is 1, n is 2, n is 3. So n values are natural number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What are these? These are natural numbers. So we have to mention here this n belong to natural number. Natural means capital N. And what is the maximum value here? 7. These all are the values of N. These all are natural number. What is the maximum value here? Maximum value is 7. That means these all values are less than 8. So we have to write here N is less than 8. So this is the final solution of this question. So like this you have to do all the remaining part of this question number 5th. Now come to question number 6. Question number 6. Write the following set in tabular form. We have to write in tabular form. First part, x such that x is equal to n upon n plus 1, where n belongs to natural number and n value are less than equal to 9. This is n is less than equal to 9. So we have to write in tabular form. Tabular form means we have to write the elements in braces and we have to separate them with the help of commas. So we will start working on this question. Formula is given. This is the formula to find the value of x. What is the formula? Formula is x is equal to n upon n plus 1. Now what are n? N are natural number. and here it is written n values are less than 9. So in n, which value we have to take? We have to take natural number, and those values should be less than 9, and equal to sign is there, then we have to take 9 also. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These all values we have to take in n. So we will put here, put n is equal to 1. When we will put here 1, the answer will be x is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1, that means 1 upon 2. Now put n is equal to next value. What is the value of n next? 2. X is equal to 2 upon 2 plus 1. Here we will put 2. Here also we will put 2. 2 upon 2 plus 1, that means 2 upon 3. Now put n is equal to 3. X is equal to 3 upon 3 plus 1, that means 3 upon 4. Now put n is equal to 4. Here we will put 4. The answer will be x is equal to 4 upon 4 plus 1, that means 4 upon 5. Now we will put n is equal to 5. Here we will put n value 5. That means x is equal to 5 upon 5 plus 1. That means 5 upon 6. Put n is equal to 6. That means x is equal to 6 upon 6 plus 1. That means 6 upon 7. Put n is equal to 7. X is equal to 7 upon 7 plus 1. That means 7 upon 8. Put n is equal to 8. X is equal to 8 upon 8 plus 1. Answer will be 8 upon 9. Then put n is equal to 9. X is equal to 9 upon 9 plus 1. Answer will be 9 upon 10. So all the values of n we had placed here in this formula, and we got the values of x. This is the first value of x. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. These all are the values of x. This is the set builder form. We have to write the answer in tabular form. So we will write the answer. Answer is first 1 upon 2, second 2 upon 3, third 3 upon 4, fourth 1 4 upon 5, fifth 5 upon 6, next 1 6 upon 7, 7 upon 8, 8 upon 9, and last one is 9 upon 10. So this is the final solution of this part. So like this you have to do this question. Now see part number 6. X such that x belongs to natural number and x cube is less than 30. So we will solve it. This is the equation. We have to use this equation here. X cube is less than 30. Now what we have to do? Here it is given x belongs to natural number. So we will put here all the values of x, and those values should be natural number only. Put x is equal to 1. Suppose we are putting here x is equal to 1. Then what we have to do? 1 cube is less than 30. Here instead of x we have to take 1. 1 cube means 1 multiply 1 multiply 1. Answer will be 1 only. 1 is less than 30. Is this statement correct? Yes, this statement is correct. 1 is less than 30. That means this value we have to take. Next value is put x is equal to 2. Here we will put 2. 2 cube is less than 30. 2 cube means 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. Is less than 30. When we will multiply it, you will get the answer 8 is less than 30. Is this correct? Yes, this statement is correct. That means this x value is correct. Now we will put x is equal to 3. So here we have to put 3. 3 cube is less than 30. When we will multiply 3, 3 times, 3 multiply 3 multiply 3, answer will be 27. 27 is less than 30. Is this statement correct? Yes, this one is also correct. That means this x value we have to consider. When we will put 4 here, 4 cube, answer will be 64. 64 is less than 30. That statement will be wrong. So we will not solve that x value. We will not solve for that x value. X is equal to 4. No, now this question is over. Now we have to write the answer. Answer is, in this set, we have to write the value of x. What are the values of x? X value is 1. X value is 2. X value is 3. This is the final solution of this part number 6. So like this, you have to do all the remaining part of this question number 6. Now come to question number 7. Express the following set in set builder form. We have to write in set builder form. First part, 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, and so on. This is the question, first part. What is the question? 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, and so on. This is roster form. We have to write in set builder form. Set builder form means we have to write the common property. Here in denominator nothing is given, so we will take here 1. Now what we will observe here, in the numerator numbers are same. 1, 1, 1, 1, these all numbers are same. But in denominator 1 is there, after that 2, after that 3, after that 4. So what you have to do, we have to write the common property here. We will start working. We have to write in set builder form. In set builder form, beginning, how we will do x such that, this is the beginning of the set builder form. These all are the values of x. So x is equal to, we will make one formula here. These all are the values of x. So x is equal to, in the numerator all the values we are observing that 1 is there. So in the numerator we will take 1. But in denominator we are seeing that here 1 is there, here 2, 3, 4. These values are getting changed. So we will give here one alphabet name. Let's say this alphabet is N. Now what is this N? This N is 1, this N is 2, this N is 3, this N is 4. That means these all numbers are natural numbers. So we have to mention here this N belong to natural number, and these natural numbers are written. But what is the last value? Last value we don't know, so we will not mention here. N value is less than 1. So this is your final answer of this first part. Now see part number 3. Third part is 0, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40. So this is the question. This is tabular form and we have to write in set builder form. So set builder form, how we will do beginning? X such that, this is the beginning. Now what are these? These numbers are the multiple of 4. These all numbers are the multiple of 4. 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12, 4 4 is 16. These all numbers are coming in a table of 4. That's why we will make one formula here. X is equal to 4 multiply N. These all are the values of X. So X equal 4 multiply N. This is the formula for the multiple of 4. Now what is this N? We have to see. First value is 0. How we will make 0? If we will use this formula, x is equal to 4n. So 4 into n value we have to put 0, then only we will get 0. If we will put n value 2, 4 into 2, answer will be 8. If we will put 4 n value 1, so we will get 4 into 1, 4. If we will put 3, we will get 12. If we will put 4, we will get 16. So what we will observe? These all values are of n. As we go on further, these values will get increased. So what are these? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. These all are whole number. They starts from 0. That's why they are whole number. See this. 0. 4 into 0 will be 0. 4 into 1 will be 4. 8. 4 into 2 will be 8. Like this, it will go on. What is the last value? 40. 4 into 10 will be 40. Okay. So these all are the values of x. 4 is coming in each number. So this 4 will remain as it is. These numbers are getting changed. 0, 1, 2. After that, 3 will be there. After that, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Like that, it will come. So what we will observe? Okay, these n values starts from 0. N values starts from 0 and finishing on 10. That means n belongs to whole number. Why whole number? Because first value of n is 0 and 0 come under the category of whole number. Now n values, last value of n is 10. That means n values are less than 11. So we will write here n is less than 11. This is the solution of this question. So like this, you have to do all the remaining part of this question.